Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to switch between apps, desktops, windows, and tabs. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when you're using your Mac, you're almost always multitasking. You've got multiple apps open, you've got multiple windows inside those apps, and sometimes even tabs inside those windows. We can even have multiple desktops. So how do you switch between all of these things? So first, let's talk about apps. I have several apps open here, and the easiest way to switch between the apps that I already have running is to use the app switcher. That's simply to hold the command key down and then tap tab on your keyboard. The switcher comes up, and every time you use tab, you move forward in the list. Shift tab moves backwards, and then when you release the command key, whichever app is highlighted will move to the front. Now, of course, you can also switch apps lots of other ways. For instance, you can just click the window if you can see it. So for instance, here I see the calculator window peeking through behind TextEdit. If I click that, it will bring that window to the front, and calculator is now the app that I'm using. But you could also switch to another app the same way you launch it. So when you go to launch an app, if it isn't running, it will launch. But if it's already running, it just brings that to the front. So for instance, I could use the dock here and go to Pages. And you can see it brings all of the Pages windows to the front. Pages was already running. That's okay. It's just another way to bring things to the front. Any other way you use to launch an app, you can also use to bring an app to the front. So I could use Spotlight with Command Space, look for TextEdit, and then you can see it just brought that to the front. It was already an open app. So Mission Control allows you to have multiple desktops. I'm going to use Command Up Arrow here, and you can see I have one desktop. I add another. And you can see I can move a window. Let's move TextEdit over to desktop number 2. Now I can use Mission Control to select the desktop like that. So I can activate it again with Control Up Arrow and go to desktop 1. But I also have a couple shortcuts to do this. Using Control and Right Arrow or Left Arrow will switch between these desktops. And using 4 fingers on the trackpad, I can swipe to the left or the right to go between the desktops. Now this also works with full screen windows. So let's take this Pages window full screen. If I look at Mission Control now, you can see I've got 2 desktops and a full screen app. Each of these is called a space. So I have 3 spaces and use the same controls for these. I can use Control Right Arrow to go between them and Control Left Arrow to go back. And I can use 4 fingers on the trackpad to go back and forth between them, or just go to Mission Control and select the one I want to jump to. Now how about windows inside an app? So here in Pages, I have 3 windows open. I can see that, and one way to switch between them is by going to Window, and you can see these 3 windows here. So even if the windows are on different desktops or maybe one's in full screen mode, I can see all of them here and jump to one by selecting it. I could also use the keyboard shortcut Command and then the backtick or tilde key. On American keyboards, it's right above the tab. If I use that, it's like switching apps, but I'm switching between the windows in the app that I'm currently using. You also can use the dock for this. So here's Pages, and if I click and hold, you could see the 3 windows I have open, and they have little window icons next to them. Above that, you also see recent documents. So these are documents that aren't open, whereas these are documents that are and each have their own window, and I could select one to go to it. You could also use Mission Control for this. If I use Control and Up Arrow, notice that in addition to desktops here at the top, I see all of the windows in the current desktop. So not just the ones for Pages, but also in this case there's System Preferences, there's TextEdit, and there's Calculator. So I don't have to switch desktops here. I can just jump to a window by clicking on it. Go to each one. There's also a way to just bring up the windows in your current app. So I'm using Pages now. If I use Control and Down Arrow, it'll show me the windows for the current app and also other recent documents here at the bottom. And now what about if you're using tabs instead of windows? So in Pages, I'm going to go to Window, Merge All Windows. So now all of these are in one window, and there are 3 different tabs. And you can move between the tabs by simply clicking on the tabs like that. Also notice in Pages under Window, these tabs are still represented here in the Window menu, so I can jump to one that way. And you can use special keyboard shortcuts, which you can see here under Window. Show Next Tab is Control and then Tab. And then Control Shift Tab goes backwards. So Control Tab goes to the next tab. And I can continue to loop through. In Safari, things are a little bit different with tabs. Under Window, you won't see all of the different tabs listed here in Window. But you can use Control and then Tab to go between your tabs, or Shift, Control, and Tab to go backwards. And of course, you can also click on each one of these. And there's an additional set of shortcuts. If you use Command and a number, you can go to the specific tab. So Command 1 goes to the first tab. Command 3 goes to the third tab. Command 9 will always go to the last tab. So 1 through 8 work for the first 8 tabs, and 9 is always the last tab if you happen to have more than 9. So as you can see, you always have multiple ways to switch between things, whether it's spaces, applications, windows, or tabs. And there's always a way to do it with the mouse or trackpad, and also a way to do it with the keyboard. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.